All right, in our living room, as you walk in, there's on this side a gallery of our family, grandchildren, children, husbands and wives, and so forth. And on this side, we have each of the individual shots of our kids. And on top is a painting done by Arnold Friberg of the prayer at Valley Forge, which he signed for us. So I cut my teeth on television news, and I had the opportunity to be a stringer or a freelance photographer for Channel 4, the ABC affiliate in the Salt Lake market. And one of the things I enjoyed doing was enterprising my own stories. And sometimes I'd go after my own heroes and do a story about them. And one of them was Arnold Friberg, who was a master artist and an illustrator because he came from the same art school as Norman Rockwell. And I had the opportunity to go to his studio to do his story. Nobody ever got a chance to film him painting because that was a very sacred thing to him.
It takes me back to Galilee, you know. Well, what do you mean back? We, none of us had been there, but there's something in us, I think there's something in people that have roots way back. I like to pay tribute to whatever I paint.
Like an actor assuming his role on stage, Arnold Friberg has played the part of every portrait he has painted.
There's a certain hero worship in me ever since I was a kid. I was a skinny kid in high school. I've never lost this sort of hero worship. So you try to paint someone who fits the role, shall we say.
Friberg got his start painting his heroes, doing an advertising series for a paper company that was falling on hard times during the Depression. The image and symbolism of the Royal Mounted Police portrayed a convincing strength, which brought the failing company new revenues and success.
Mounted Police said to me, you must have belonged to the force. You couldn't have pictured us that way unless you rode with us. They said, you must have belonged. Well, they said, we'll make you one right now. They pinned the badge on me then and there. And they're resourceful men. They're very honorable men. They would die rather than bring disgrace upon the force, you know. When I paint Nephi, I'm not trying to paint Crusher Kowalski.
Although the Book of Mormon had been in print for over 100 years, it was Friberg who really captured the characters of an ancient people who once lived in America. These 12 paintings originally appeared in a children's magazine of the LDS Church.
It's the spirit that I'm painting, which is always larger than our bodies. I think people feel that. And mind you, if it's a good painting, a powerful painting, doesn't say the artist, this is the artist's concept. It tends to say this really happened. So I paint things that I believe in.
Tomorrow, Arnold Friberg will talk about his greatest hero, who never appeared on his canvas, and a royal commission never before done by an American. Living at the foot of Mount Olympus, Arnold Friberg was inspired by the majesty of this Utah peak when he created the concept of Mount Sinai for the motion picture, The Ten Commandments.
The motion picture was made from the paintings. The paintings were not made from the motion pictures.
Cecil B. DeMille employed Friberg to develop the costumes and images to be portrayed on film.
I say I did inspirational work. It was the guide, you know, that I had to conceive of the scenes in pictorial form.
Behold his mighty hand!
Friberg, who admires events and people that stand greater than life, was awed to work with a man he felt was a living epic.
His pictures have been probably a larger inspiration on my work than even the great painters. DeMille was simply, I guess, the greatest pioneer of the motion picture industry. He was much greater than the legend, much greater man than the legend. He ran right through to the core and heart of everything. The boots, these are the boots of Prince Charles. See, I did the portrait of him.
No American has ever been commissioned to do a royal painting before. However, Friberg was not awarded the assignment for his talents as an epic artist, but for his 300 paintings of the Canadian Mounted Police.
The easiest man to get along with I met in England. Very good sense of humor. I think England's lucky to have him.
Arnold Friberg is a modern master. His passions are the heroes and nostalgic times recreated by his brush. And perhaps he himself has become a modern hero.